at the WTT Champions Macau. See what happens here. Mukherjee with the serve.
She's trying to change the spin. She is kind of flipping the racket. Maybe she's trying to test the waters, how she's going to react to the balls.
Umpire just saying toss it a little bit more vertically, a little bit more high, please, Mukherjee. She's got a forehand, the Indian, which I couldn't help but smile at watching yesterday. So different to the technique of the majority of professional players.
Oh, absolutely, because she kind of puts the throw on the racket completely. She kind of throws her complete weight on the... A pretty punchy forehand she has.
I think it's safe to say her footwork isn't the best, so I think Yuan Zhanlan is going to try and get her corner to corner. But if she's in the position to play the shot, she can play with high quality, Sarithra.
Oh, absolutely.
Had a good campaign alongside Aithika Mukherjee in the women's doubles. Got to the main draw. Now eliminated. Unfortunately for the Indian fans. Whoa! She just counteracted that. Didn't expect her to get the first Yuan Zhanlan forehand back. Brace for impact and returned a few more. And then look at that. Just counters that. A good start for the Indian. He played a few seasons back in January and Yuan Zhanlan won 3-0. So she's never won a game in a best of five against this player, even though they've only played once, to be fair.
Oh wow, it's a powerful backhand. Good comeback on the point. I guess in this season of WTT Goa, or I would say this chapter of WTT Goa, players from all over India has come, kids from all over India has come to see how their icons are playing, how the world icons play together. I think it's a great exposure Indians are getting.
As a kid, when you're like a sponge, you just absorb whatever you see and hear. Brilliant to be so close to the action. They're going to take so much away from this.
Yes, actually, from the recording matches, you may not get that kind of experience, but when you're seeing the ball so closely, you start seeing the game, observing the game, smelling the game. Oh, it's a slap by the Sudhirtha Mukherjee.
Hearing the game too, and you can hear the contact was like a crashing cymbal there. The ball was high enough to hit flat, didn't need to spin it.
Yeah.
See that more commonly in the women's game, women slapping with the forehand, apart from, of course, Matthias Falk.
Johan is trying to keep her actually locked on her backhand, and she's trying to place the ball on different positions on the backhand, and then she kind of finishes towards the extreme backhand.
Pushed, and Yuan Zhanlan just a little bit upright. I don't think she was expecting it so deep on the table. She's up against her opponent that she's expecting herself to beat, but she's still got to take this match 100% seriously, as though she's playing Wang Manyu again. Of course, different tactics, though.
Oh, little change of space by Mukherjee. I don't know whether it was a deliberate attempt. Looked like that she fell a little short, but it's a good, comfortable lead. She has 2 points. I think she would definitely want to go for this point.
Well. This is interesting, isn't it? I tell you. She's up against the world number 18. She is ranked, get this, 147.
I guess, yes, in terms of ranking, she is much low. Looks like that she is determined and confident, and she wants to display a good game.
6-8.
Well, Yuan Zhanlan may clench a fist there, but wasn't a great receive, and a player of a bit higher quality would have put that away, for sure. Got to just try and keep it a little bit lower over the net, but with the forehand side, difficult to do that, Yuan Zhanlan. There's the quality. She got nice dwell on that ball.
I guess Supitra can actually draw a lot of learnings from Miwa Harimoto. She doesn't take pressure, she smiles in the match. You have nothing to lose when you're playing with such amazing players. You have nothing to lose. You should keep the pressure less on yourself.
Brilliant recovery. Nice blocking on the table, changing it around. And she's 9-7 up here on one of the best players in Europe.
It's a powerful rally she kind of played.
Maybe she's a bit, she struggles a bit with players who use pimples as well, Yuan Jianan.
She is not just missing her forehand slap.
Look at that face.
I think she wants to win this point. It will definitely give her a good amount of confidence and Indian fans as well.
Well, possessed by ambition, Sutirtha Mukherjee here in the Mukherjee Stadium on home soil is 1-0 up for Indian table tennis.
Oh yes, I think the more icons, the more star players we create, I think it's good for the audience as well, and it kind of gives them more confidence with more players, more Indian names are coming up.
That is mental. Forehand slap.
Wow, I think it's not easy to come back with a slap because you kind of apply Newton's third law there. The ball comes with the same speed.
Yes, equal and opposite force, right?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Oh, well. She was blinded by the lights.
Or is it the pressure?
Perhaps an element of both, but she does rub the eyes, and there are a lot of lights beaming down. You see some players come onto the table before they play just to test the flight of the ball. But she screwed that one up.
She's kind of switching the racket pretty fast. I think she kind of dominates with both the hands, backhand and forehand.
She's just making the transition from forehand from the backhand side back to neutral position a little bit slow, Yuan Jianan, and her feet don't move too quickly. Her game is reliant upon switching her opponent first. If you do the same to her earlier, you can beat her.
Looks like Sutirtha is playing a very mature game. She's not at all intimidated by the player. And what a point she won.
This is incredible. Honestly, I'm speechless with how she's playing now, Sachin.
She kind of threw her entire body, entire force towards the forehand.
Ooh, yeah, good switch there. What from Yuan Jianan. It's not a game of footwork, it's a game of switching because of the fact that neither player's footwork is their strength.
How
interesting is this?
I think that makes the table tennis game actually very, very interesting against playing the various kind of spins and also the spin absorption that happens because of the pimple rubbers.
Well, she guarantees at least a 2-point cushion here. And she's playing like she's the favourite now, Sutirtha Mukherjee. This is a remarkable spectacle.
I can see she is not at all intimidated by the opponent.
Yeah, she's gone past the point of being nervous and struggling to express herself on the table. She really is just playing against the opponent now, and it seems like Yuan Jianan is fighting herself as well as the Indian.
I guess if we can somehow switch off our mind and not see the ranking and just see players as player, possibly we can allow ourselves best to come out. And that's what possibly we are seeing in the case of Sutirtha Mukherjee. 27-year-old. Playing against Yuan, 37-year-old, experienced, much more experienced.
Much more decorated. Well, that is not going to help the French Revolution.
8-2 lead. I think she would want to stop the Yuan over here only.
Do you know what? Can't help but get carried away here, but say Sutirtha Mukherjee won this match, she'd be playing against another player who has a really beatable style, I think, for her game. Fu Yu of Portugal, who uses a traditional penhold style. Mukherjee could beat her, I think, stylistically, the way she's playing now, and reach the quarter final. Could you imagine that?
I think the way Indian table tennis is kind of is at a high at the moment. I have never seen a high before, and I guess slowly and slowly, with the help of other opponents like Manika Batra, Sharad Kamal, Satyan, everyone, every player seems to be gaining more confidence.
So it's 8-5, 5 serving 8. Yuan Jianan no longer confident on the high toss. Timeout call, great timeout in my opinion. Mm. 8-6. Well, she had her face in the towel for quite some time in the corner there. She's just got to believe. It can become real when you find yourself in these kind of leads. You start to think about the possibility of beating a player like Yuan Jianan, and you can freeze up if you're not careful. And it seems like that's happening. She's tensing slightly, the Indian.
She is kind of playing a slow game at the moment. She is. Stirta has to come up the ball if she has to hit it fast, because she knows that if she is kind of hitting it on the third line, Sutirta is kind of hitting it on the top. So she's trying to play a little closer on the table.
Wow. Very, very awkward third ball for Yuan Jianan to try and block. It was slow. It was shallow on the table.
It was right between the first line and the second line, and I think that's the most dangerous place in table tennis if the player is actually standing a little far.
Well, this is more like it from her. She's got 3 game points. Mukherjee's. This is an incredible performance. Can she go 2-0 up here on a player ranked so much higher than her? The net cord keeps Yuan Jianan's hopes alive. She's played poorly, the French player, but that's credit to the Indian, really, for the way that she's varied things, and her style definitely helps.
I've seen 8-10 is a very, very difficult score, specifically the one who is maintaining a lead.
Wow. Controlled percentage play. This right here, ladies and gentlemen, could be the biggest upset. Wow, Yuan Jianan did brilliantly there just to stay in it. Two good switches down the line for Sutirtha Mukherjee, whose best win in her career was probably Bernadette Such, who she beat about 3 years ago. So she has beaten some players who've been top 20 in the world. She's beaten Batra as well back in 2021. Less impressive beating a teammate than it is beating one of the big threats to your team, because obviously you know your teammate's game all so well. Yuan Jianan has a very difficult playing style to disrupt, even for the top Chinese, and she's proved that against Wang Manyu, who she beat last season. Now she's playing the right way. The coach said that to her last game. But I think it's just important now that she stays calm and doesn't see the finish line, doesn't think about the finish line.
Absolutely, you are right. Because we have seen several times that 2-0 up and then you kind of go to the decider. You have to play at this moment, you have to play point by point. You do not have to think about the match. You do not have to think about anything at the moment.
Too hot to handle with that forehand. Wide, direct.
Some advice from the audience. Sumadeep Roy, again a powerful player from India.
Nice wide punch. She's a flat hitter. And if the ball's high enough, which Yuen Jianan's forehand really, really was, she can play like that. She was made to look good there by Yuen Jianan's poor attack.
I think Sudhirta is playing a pretty mature game, even if the opponent is maintaining a lead. She's trying to come back in the match. She is not at all intimidated by the ranking or the seniority of the player. She's trying to play the very, very mature game. I guess the power of the forehand, which has also been switched in the backhand. You can see these slaps completely coming out of it. And I think this is the game she needs to play. If the ball is coming short, she needs to come ahead on the top of the ball because she kind of puts through the complete power.
It's tricky now for Yuen Jianan because Mukherjee's always serving long. Yuen Jianan is always going to attack those balls, but Mukherjee's beating her in the rally. She has her on toast, the Indian. Yuen Jianan, I think, though, should try and make it wider earlier, perhaps into the wide forehand of the Indian to stretch her. Because side to side, she's not massively quick, Mukherjee. All that play with slow spin, which you can only do with the backhand side, Yuen Jianan, due to her style and equipment choice.
Absolutely. I guess you cannot get relaxed on any point in this kind of a matches where you're so close.
She's leveled it with one foot in the air on that backhand block.
And if you see very closely, she's trying to hit more and more ball from the backhand now. She kind of changed her position, came in the center. Great display of technique, great display of resilience, great display of hunger in India, in front of the Indian fans, giving some hope to the Indian contingent.
She's not going to miss that one. Yuen Jianan didn't know how to deal with that slow, controlled, caressing forehand. Sudhirta Mukherjee, and she's forced Yuen Jianan into a timeout. It was a bad start from the Indian. It looked like she might be bottling it a little bit, but now she finds herself back in front. Wow. Well, again, is at the moment where we begin to think, could it be? Could this be real?
She came again very heavily from the forehand. That's her dominating point.
Oh my God, Sachin, can you please hold my microphone while I just give my glasses a little clean? Is this real?
Absolutely. This is absolutely real. Goa is a very relaxed place, but you see a very, very powerful match happening over here. And she is 4 points up. I don't think so she would want to give up.
It's 4 match points to Sudhirta Mukherjee. That's one way to serve match point. Yuen Jianan.
The interesting point you see is that Yuan had to win this point and exactly hitting one in the corner on the third line, which is not so easy.
She's done it. This 27-year-old from West Bengal, Sudhirta Mukherjee, has done it. Playing for a nation with barely any table tennis infrastructure at all. She's topped one of the best players in the world, Yuen Jianan.